Once again, this is Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. Broad lines for prescribing a DMARD for your autoimmune rheumatic disease. This video is about the many factors that interplay in the process of prescribing the most suitable medicines to treat your autoimmune rheumatic disease. The aim is to make you more aware of how doctors treat your arthritis and also to make you more convinced that you cannot doctor in your arthritis. Doctoring remains the doctor's job. In this video, we have three main subtopics. We start with quickly revising what we know from so far from the previous videos concerning the prescribing of the DMARDs, adding to this the complete list of factors that guide the rheumatologist's choice of medication, and a final word reminding you of the most important benefit you get from a DMARD. Okay, let's make the quick revision. When it comes to prescribing non-biological DMARDs, the rule is, give me the name of the affected organ, I give you your medication options. You can refer to the video titled Non-Biological DMARDs for more details. So if inflammation is mainly in your joints, arthritis, those are your options. If inflammation is mainly in the kidneys, nephritis, those are your options. If it's in the muscles, called myositis, those are your options. On the other hand, that was the non-biological DMARDs now. How about biologicals? When it comes to prescribing biological DMARDs, oh, how many? There are so many, huh? The rule is, give me the name of your disease, I give you your medication options. If your disease is rheumatoid arthritis, those are your biological medication options. You can stop the video to watch them more, of course. If it's psoriatic arthritis, those are your options here. If your disease is ankylosing spondylitis, here are your options. If it's Still's disease, here are the options. If it's systemic lupus, those two are the options, and so on. Sounds so easy, huh? I'm pretty sure that some patients, not all patients of course, up to this point at least, might strongly believe that prescribing or treating their arthritis is a piece of cake. Even a patient or a non-doctor anyway can do it. Just know the name of the organ or the disease, and those are the names of the medications that you can use. Well, that's quite far from the truth. Now, I will provide you with the list of factors that guide the doctor's choice of which medication to prescribe to whom. Prescribing is not only about merely knowing names of medications. It's about much more than that. For every organ in your body, we mentioned different non-biological options. For every autoimmune disease, we mentioned different biological medication options. So on what basis do we choose which medication to prescribe or which medications to combine in a patient with an autoimmune rheumatic disease? On the basis of several more factors. Factor one. Factor one, assessment of two important aspects of your disease. This is very important. This is the start. Those two aspects are, number one, how inflamed your joints are. Number two, how aggressive your disease tends to be. Now, those are two different aspects of assessment. How inflamed your joints can be mildly inflamed or severely inflamed. You can have mild pain or severe pain, for example, mild swelling or more aggressive swelling. Now, how aggressive your disease tends to be, this is about prognosis. This is about the future, how we can foretell where this arthritis or where this disease is taking you in the future. Like, for example, is this joint disease a deforming disease or it will not turn out to be a deforming disease? Those two aspects, as I said, are not the same. Your joints might not be so inflamed at this point in time, but there are signs that your disease is an aggressive one in the future. And the opposite is true. Your joints might be so intensely inflamed right now, but I can tell that this is a benign disease, that it is not troublesome in the future. What is the importance of assessment of the disease? Assessment will sort out the disease into milder and less troublesome disease, and more severe and more troublesome disease. The milder will be prescribed non-biological DMARDs, and likely they will do, and the more severe, of course, it will initially be prescribed also non-biological DMARDs, but if the more severe, we know that it will likely be prescribed biological DMARDs also if the non-biologicals do not work. So the value of the assessment here, I know what to prescribe now, and I also know where probably I will be going later. Another value of assessment, A subgrading of our assessment will also sort out the milder disease into more mild and not that mild, and the severe disease into not that severe and more severe. And what's the importance of that? The importance of that is that the non-biological DMARDs family and the biological DMARDs family also have subgrades of potency of their medications. Look at that. If it is so mild on the left side, you can start with plaquenil and salasopyrin. If it is not that mild, you know you go for methotrexate or arava. The more severe, you also have a grading. Enbrel is less immunosuppressing and less potent than mabthera, which is more potent, at least theoretically. So this is even allowing for more optimal prescribing according to the subgrading of the inflammation that you have. Another factor, factor number two, your medication use history. What medications you used before that worked for you? Some of them are cards that I can use still. What medications you used before that did not work for you? We should not try them again. I should not waste your time with those medications again. Did not work or failed is about efficacy and about adverse effects. What does that mean? It means that a medicine that is so good for your arthritis, but that at the same time causes troublesome side effects is considered a medication that failed. And still, in the medication use history, what other medications you are using for any other medical condition? If you had thrombosis, for example, thrombosis of the vessels, and are receiving anticoagulants, blood thinners, to prevent thrombosis again. There are certain medications for your arthritis that we would prefer to use more than others, and certain medications that we would avoid more than others. In other words, what other medications you are using for any other medical condition that might interact with what we want to prescribe and contraindicate or prevent its use. Another factor, factor three, what other medical conditions you suffer from. If you have, if you're having an abscess or other infection now, I cannot prescribe most of my DMARDs until the abscess has been treated. If you have liver or kidney impairment, there are certain medications that I cannot prescribe or that I should prescribe with adjusted doses. If you have diabetes and are receiving medications to control blood sugar, there are certain medications for your arthritis that we would prefer to use more than others, and certain medications that we would avoid more than others. Another factor, any previous medical conditions that you had before. If you had tuberculosis before, certain medications will be better avoided or prescribed with special measures taken. If you had cancer before, certain medications will be better avoided. Another factor, availability. Is what I need to prescribe available in this country or available in the pharmacies or not? Another factor, financial issues. They do play a role, especially in the patient who does not have insurance coverage. And insurance issues, will the insurance company approve or make this medication available? Another factor, what you prefer. A patient will tell me, I don't like injections. Another will tell me, I prefer injections. I don't want many treatments. I don't want that particular medication. Frequency of dosing and the convenience of the dosing. What your situation dictates. You work in the oil field and you come back home every 3 weeks. A weekly injection is not practical, but a monthly one would be perfect. So those are the many, many factors that interplay when we prescribe a DMARD for a patient. Now, the last point in this video, the most important benefit you get from a DMARD. Always remember that DMARDs are very important for the control of your autoimmune rheumatic disease. The most important benefit that you get from a DMARD is that when it works for you, it can very satisfactorily control your disease and prevent its progression. Now, that was the end of that video. The next video answers one of the most important patient questions. Infections. DMARDs and infections. Will I get infections if I use DMARDs? Well, that is a possibility, of course. And this video is about what doctors do to make sure patients on DMARDs don't get infections.